We wrap up day number one of the BCS playoffs, game number four. It's Michigan State and Georgia in the Poinsettia Bowl from Qualcomm Stadium. We have some rain in the forecast here in San Diego. It's the San Diego County Credit Union Poinsettia Bowl as we figure out who team number two from bracket number one is going to be that moves on to the very next round between the Georgia Bulldogs and the Michigan State Spartans. Two teams that are in their conference championship and two teams that lost those games. And Georgia, they are the higher seed. They are at number 16. As you see the Spartans taking the field, they got the pick. They got pick number 16. They got the last pick of all the teams of the remaining bowl games. The only bowl game that was left for them to take was the Poinsettia Bowl. Both teams having to make a cross-country trek. But as we say in the BCS playoffs, more games count. And by virtue of losing their last two games of the year, they get punished by being seeded 16 and 17 and being forced to come far across the country here over to San Diego. Certainly the furthest trip that any of these teams have had to make all year. And taking a look at Rambo for the Georgia Bulldogs, and we wrap up what has been a really fun but long day here at the BCS playoffs, and it's only going to continue on to Friday and into Saturday. We not only have this game going on, but right now on the deuce, it's the Meineke Car Care Bowl of Texas as part of the second NIT game where Missouri and Ohio are going at it. So we have some light rain in the forecast, some cold breeze, but that's not going to stop the BCS playoffs from rolling on here in San Diego. And not only have the fans traveled well from Georgia and traveled well from Michigan, but also some fans here in the San Diego area interested to see a really good ball game between the Big Ten and the SEC. We're going to kick things off with Michigan State and Kirk Cousins overthrowing his wide receiver for an incomplete pass. Again, if you're just looking to see your favorite teams, spoiler warnings mean nothing to you, but if you haven't watched the games in order, this is your fair spoiler warning to move ahead if you don't want to hear anything. But for Michigan State, Big Ten, they are the first Big Ten team in action. They're looking to move on while the SEC is already 0-1 in the BCS playoffs, while the ACC, if you're counting the NIT games, they're already 3-0. Third down for Cousins. First down, Michigan State. What a way for these guys to convert. These guys, Michigan State and Georgia, actually met in the BCS playoffs a couple of years ago. So it's pretty interesting to see them meeting up here again as you see Kirk Cousins found his intended wide receiver, actually the tight end. That was Linthicum, Brian Linthicum, to get a fresh set of downs here on a rainy day. And they're letting Cousins throw it on this rainy day. Nice blocking. That one's going to be screened out. That one was screened out to the other tight end. That was Derek Hogelbane. Second and seven. Now they are going to hand it off. That one is given to Edwin Baker. Very few on the ground. It'll be third down and five. Cousins and shotgun, no backs. Dropped, incomplete. Couldn't hang on to it in the slippery rain. You see it coming down is the rain. That one was intended for wide receiver Beanie Fowler. And this is where the Georgia Bulldogs will take over. Again, both teams, they are reeling from a defeat in their conference championships, which is why they're being forced to play here in San Diego. But not a bad way to close out what's been a fun day of bowl games on the very first day of the bowl championship series. Murray, though, needed to get rid of it, and he couldn't do it even when he got knocked down by the defender, who was Ty Hamilton, the linebacker, who still hopped right back up to his feet and took down Aaron Murray. And Murray's either got to run with it or he's got to get rid of it. Didn't do either of them. Now he finds himself into the turf. 7-yard sack for the Bulldogs. Murray. That's an open man. That's going to be a first down. Just really good route running on the play. That's wide receiver Michael Bennett. Bennett's had 31 receptions on the year. Caught 5 touchdowns. There's Harry Dog. He made the long trek to San Diego. San Diego County Credit Union Poinsettia Bowl, the site of the Miami, Ohio upset over Stanford last season. That one was an inside, or kind of an outside handoff to Isaiah Crowell, who finally they sent him the right number. Those of you that tuned into our BCS preview game, you know what I'm talking about there. Second down and 7, pitches it outside to Crowell. Crowell gets it past midfield, but no further. And a third down and 4. He had a lot of fumbles in that game against LSU. We'll see if he can keep it under control today. So far, 2 for 2. Not bad. Murray slips. Just able to get his footing. He goes down the field, and it's going to be incomplete. Murray losing his footing here on this grass at Qual. It's not Qualcomm Stadium anymore. That's where Michigan State is going to take over. It's going to be around the 12-yard line. Inside handoff to Baker. Gain of no yards. Second and 10. Kirk Cousins over the middle. In there for a 7-yard gain. He found wide receiver Keith Nickel. But this is still called Qualcomm Stadium, isn't it? I swear I thought they changed the name there. Oh, there he goes down. It's going to be a fourth down. It is still Qualcomm Stadium. First and 10, really nice field position for the Georgia Bulldogs. In this kind of weather, this is going to be a ground and pound kind of game. Let's try to score when you can. Second and 11 after the failed run by Isaiah Crowell. Very young Georgia Bulldogs team. They give it to Crowell again. Crowell is able to get 6 on the run. Be a third down and 5. They are into Spartan territory. The winner of this game, you get rewarded with either playing LSU or Louisiana Tech. That game will be decided tomorrow. Then first down for the Georgia Bulldogs to Bennett. So the winner of this game, if they play LSU, we pretty much think that it's going to be the Chick-fil-A Bowl that LSU will take. If Louisiana Tech wins, though, then whoever wins this game will get their pick of the bowl game, but chances are they're going to be at the bottom of that list due to their ranking, so it'll be kind of up of who is going to get that choice of bowl, but we'll get to that point when we get it. That's Johnny Adams with the deflection from Akron, Ohio. So he probably has some family that came out to this one, because Ohio... Right there, kind of come over. Second and 10, completed pass, making it a third down and run. Third down and 1. Some route running by wide receiver King. King is the third leading receiver on this Bulldogs team. Third down and 1, and I dare say, give it to Isaiah Crowell. That's what they are going to do. Crowell gives him the first down, stays on his feet, and he's down to the 14-yard line. Maybe the 13. Let's see where Hockey Lee Jr. wants to put it down at. We have come to the end of the first quarter, and we are scoreless between number 16 and number 17, the Bulldogs and the Spartans. Michigan State, we remember last season, they jumped out to a 17-0 lead over Hawaii in the Pinstripe Bowl. Hawaii would score 21 unanswered and win that game to send the Spartans home early. They don't want to go out in the second round again. As for the Bulldogs, they weren't even a part of the BCS playoffs last season. Screen pass to Crowell. He fumbles it. He immediately goes up, goes back down. You're going to see some fumbles in the rain. Look at that. It looked like he just, maybe some back spasms or something. Second and 15. Cold and rainy night here in San Diego. This time it's not Crowell who ran it. That was Carlton Thomas who comes in for Crowell. He's got it for 71 carries on the year, 361 yards, and Thomas is able to get it down the field to make it a respectable third down and two. Possibly going to run it again, but we do have Murray in shotgun. Murray's going to throw it on a third and two. Interesting play call from Mark Richt. It doesn't work out for him. He had a receiver, but instead it's going to be fourth and two, and the Bulldogs are going to go for it. Gutsy Mark Richt. We've been talking about how he's been on the hot seat. Well, when you're on the hot seat, you're going to go. Look at that. Carlton Thomas, touchdown. What a decision on fourth down to go for it by Mark Richt. Thomas was met by three Spartans at the line. He was able to break through, and there's Uga, who's on the field at the 50-yard line. And the Georgia Bulldogs, pending this point after attempt, about to be up 7-0. Kick is away. Kick is good. Carlton Thomas, 10 plays, 52 yards, almost 2 minutes. That's a good way to eat up that clock. Now it's time for Kirk Cousins and the Spartans to try to respond. Can they do it against this tough SEC defense? They're going to get the ball at the 22-yard line to start off their next offensive drive. D'Antonio, head coach of Michigan State. Kirk Cousins on the option, keeps it himself. He's able to get a yard. Kirk Cousins, the kind of quarterback at times, when he's good, he is on fire, but when he's bad, he is just plain bad. It's either one way or the other with this guy. Wide receiver sweep. No, it wasn't. It was Edwin Baker, pardon me. Running back sweep. I beg your pardon. Running back sweep for Baker, be third down and six. Cousins is back to pass. Cousins has a receiver, first down, Michigan State. Trying to get a number on him, 82 is the one that got it. That's Keyshawn Martin. Sparty, look at the moves of Sparty, look at the footwork. That's impressive. Easy on that camera shot. We don't need the FCC to get us tossed off the air or off YouTube. First and 10. Cousins is going to go down. He is sacked. 4-yard loss. That was just pressure. That was the linebackers that got in there. And then finally the lineman was able to force the tackle. And the man that eventually did get the sack was Foggy Lockie. Man with the crazy name, Fogalaga. Kirk Cousins goes down for a 4-yard loss. He's going to take this one out of shotgun. High snap, fields it with a net almost. Screen pass incomplete. He's looking for Bell. And now it's going to be 3rd and 14. Which Kirk Cousins are we getting today? It's looking like we're getting the erratic one so far. Cousins to Bell. Down he goes. Punt, punt, punt for Michigan State on 4th and 15. Time for the Bulldogs to try to add to this lead. They got plenty of time. They got over 3 minutes. Brandon Boykin, he does great things on defense for the Georgia Bulldogs team. Looks like they might be in a running situation, but now we see all this motion. They are, no, they're not, because they're going to play action it. Incomplete pass. Defense for the Spartans stands tough. In on the deflection was Denard, the cornerback, sophomore cornerback from Dry Branch, Georgia. So from his home state going up against his team. Look at Isaiah Crowell getting into Spartan territory. Finally, Shoelace tackled just inside the 50-yard line by Mitchell White. That could have been easily burned for a touchdown. Out of the gun, Murray. That's going to be an 8-yard pickup. You see D'Antonio. What is my team doing? What is going on out there? Orson Charles was the one who got the reception on that grab. It'll be 2nd and 2. They give it back off to Crowell. Crowell is in there for the first down. Harry Dog says, yes, sir. That's my team getting it done. And he says, Sparty's got some fancy footwork. Well, look at my handwork. Look at this handstand. And I don't know what the heck that was. It just popped up there. Nonetheless, 1st and 10 for the Bulldogs. They're about at the 2-minute mark. Murray takes it from the gun to the near side. Completes it. Down to the 5. Timeout is called. Screen pass. Crowell to the 2-yard line. They're going to spot it at the 3. 2nd and goal. Isaiah Crowell, touchdown, Georgia Bulldogs, 13-0 for the Bulldogs over Sparty. There you see Uga once again. I would be really impressed if Uga would be able to, you know, you might not know, you can YouTube it, but Boise State, when they kick the ball off at home, they have a dog that comes and retrieves the tee and brings it back to them. That dog got some speed to be able to do that. I want to see Uga, that big old Uga, try to run out there and retrieve the tee. I would be really impressed if that happened. But we'll see. Maybe in due time it will happen. For Sparty, though, they don't want to see any tees returned. They're just trying to get their team going because they're down early, 14-0. Keyshawn Martin on the return. They have the ball at the 24-yard line. Kirk Cousins in shotgun. 3 receivers set to the near side. And Cousins is going to hit. I believe he hit the running back, which would be Baker, Edwin Baker. 2nd and 14. And that one was to the hands of Nichols. Nichol. 1st and 10, Kirk Cousins moving the ball well. It's going to be another Michigan State first down. Here comes Sparty. Kirk Cousins starting to show those flashes of brilliance that we know he has. He's either really good or he's really bad. It's either one side or the other of the coin with this guy. You can't deny, though, the impact he's had on this Michigan State team over the last couple of years. Incomplete pass by Kirk Cousins, though, but it will stand to stop the clock. Kirk Cousins, he is a senior from Holland, Michigan, and he doesn't want his senior year to end here in the rain at the Poinsettia Bowl. He wants to go all the way. National title for Sparty. Knocked away. Really good coverage for Georgia. Again, Michigan State, they're disappointed. Last season, they went out in the first round. They were beat by Hawaii. Cousins pressured. Incomplete. You can't fault Cousins for that one. That was just really nice pressure by the Georgia D lineman. And Kirk Cousins had no choice but to just get rid of it. Here comes the kick. Field at the 15. Fumble on the play, but it is recovered by Rambo. And that could have been... Well, we got a again, I fail to see the point of these booth reviews when the team just recovers it, I guess, because they did gain a few extra yards. And it did turn out that the ground did cause the fumble. The play will be reversed. We'll take the ball back a whole 3 yards, and that's where Georgia will try to add on to their lead. That's grabbed for a first down by King, and he was hit hard, but he was able to hang on to that, so give him credit for hanging on to the ball. Tarvis King, Aaron Murray, out of bounds, incomplete. Less than a minute to go. The Bulldogs aren't willing to go into the locker room quietly. They want some more points on the board. Murray. Nabbed. Is that Crowell? No, that was not Isaiah Crowell. That one was Mitchell, Malcolm Mitchell. Third down and one, and they're going to throw it. Far side, incomplete. Michigan State defense holds. You see the rain coming down. Coming down looks like a little bit harder right now. Kick it away. Spartans will get the ball. It's going to be fielded at the 10, brought to the 16-yard line by Cunningham. 30 seconds to go here in the second quarter for Michigan State. Let's see how D'Antonio plays it. Going to play for points right now. Cousins, that's going to be a first down. Put the ball to 32. They still have one timeout. It's a long shot, but it's still a possibility. We have five wide, and now you're going to have to run no huddle. You got to tell Cousins either go for first downs or don't throw it at all, because that's going to keep the clock running. First downs will stop your clock temporarily. They're going to get the first down. He does throw it short that time, but he is still able to get the first down. Here comes the no huddle. Cousins, incomplete. With 3 seconds to go, you could almost expect this is just going to be one last throw for that big red end zone. That's about 55 yards away. Four wide receivers. Kirk Cousins is back. Cousins heaves it towards the end zone. That's caught! Oh! Touchdown for the Spartans! Unbelievable! B.J. Cunningham, 55 yards. Michigan State does it again. They know something about Hail Mary plays. They did it against Wisconsin, and they do it again to end the half. B.J. Cunningham for touchdown number 13 on the year. Michigan State, they just know for some reason how to convert on those Hail Marys. We head into the locker room as the Spartans, once trailing by 14. It is now a 7-point game at the San Diego County Credit Union Poinsettia Bowl. Folks, you do not want to go away. Lou Holtz, Mark May, Reese Davis, they're going to take it away with the ESPN halftime show. We will be right back in rainy San Diego after this from the guys up in the booth. Welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium, San Diego. It's about 9 o'clock Eastern time now. Just getting ready to hit about 7 o'clock on the West Coast, which is where we are. And let's take a look at game tracks. It's been a pretty evenly matched game in the early going. A couple of nice defensive stops, but the Georgia Bulldogs have been able to blow through with a couple of points of their own. But in the end, it was the Hail Mary, which they're not going to show, as GameTrack's focusing more so on the defense, which is playing a huge role in this rain. But at the end of that first half, Michigan State, just like they did against Wisconsin, a Hail Mary, 55 yards for the score. Screen pass from Aaron Murray for a gain of no yards. That one was tossed out to the fullback, Alexander Ogletree. Second and 10 for the Bulldogs. They give it to Crowell, and Crowell is in there for an 8-yard gain. Isaiah Crowell, the freshman, what kind of impact is he going to make on this Bulldogs team for years to come? Third down and 2. Murray slips. Murray completes it nonetheless. First down, Bulldogs. Aaron Murray hits over 100 yards passing on that completed ball to Aaron White, the tight end, who's a senior. First and 10, floats it way out there. That is caught, though, for a 3-yard gain by Michael Bennett to bring up second down and 7. Hands it off to Crowell. Crowell is hit. He gets 1 yard, but that's all he's going to get. You see the uniforms. We're starting to get a little dirty here. I believe that at Qualcomm we have the natural grass. A lot of teams have the field turf, but I do believe that still at Qualcomm Stadium, natural grass is here. Those uniforms, this field's going to get pretty dirty after a while. That's going to be quarterback sack by the Michigan State Spartans. Number 39, the safety, Trenton Robertson, the senior from Bay City, Michigan. So the Spartans, they'll get the ball back. They let Georgia drive a little bit, bend, but don't break. And that was actually his first quarterback sack of the year, as I'm pulling his numbers up here on ESPN.com. Cousins screens it to the running back. It's going to be a 1-yard pickup out to Edwin Baker. Second down and 9 for Sparty. Football just in between the 19 and the 20-yard line. Hands it off to Baker again. Well, the last one was a screen. This one was a... But Baker touched it again is what I meant. 3-yard gain. The 3rd and 6 and it's conversion time for Michigan State. Cousins with nobody in the backfield. Cousins over the middle. First down, Michigan State down to the 41-yard line. You can't get any more clutch than that on third down. That was Fowler that got it. Beanie Fowler. First down and 10. Okay. Thank you. Just had a brief advertisement there. First down and 10, inside handoff to the fullback. Your 6-yard pickup. Second down and 4. Cousins throws it incomplete. He's looking for nickel on that throw. Third down conversion is not too bad. 3 for 7. They got an opportunity. Let's convert one more. Cousins pressured. He gets it for the first down to the running back inside Georgia Bulldog territory. Edwin Baker. You see the offensive lineman was a halfback slip screen as the offensive lineman broke off the play. Kirk Cousins takes the shot, but he's able to get it out to the Baker. The offensive line blocks, and Baker gets the first down. Nice play calling by D'Antonio. This time, Baker is going to get dropped for a loss of yards. tackled by Jeff Rapp, the defensive lineman freshman from Kennesaw. Second down and 13, ball at the Georgia 45-yard line. Cousins lines up under center. They give it to Baker again, and Baker's going to get hit at the line. That was not Edwin Baker. That was Bell, Le'Veon Bell. So third down, and you're forced once again. Can they convert one more time? No, they cannot. Down he goes. Quarterback sack onto Kirk Cousins. And that was Blake Sailors that went in there and got him. And the ball usually distributed pretty evenly between Le'Veon Bell and Edwin Baker. Both with about 165 carries each. But Bell, who's been all around the more rushing yards and more touchdowns, this one is going to die at the one-yard line for Georgia. Can't ask for a better punt than that. And now Aaron Murray and company, they are on their heels. Crowell trying to break them away from that back territory. That's going to be a 4-yard run. Second and 6. Crowell once again. Crowell has an opening. There goes Isaiah Crowell. One man to beat. He's not going to get him. Down to the 30-yard line. What a run by the freshman. 70-plus yards for Isaiah Crowell. And you just get the touchdown-saving tackle by the safety Robinson from Michigan State. What a run that was for Crowell, and that might save the Bulldogs' season. Let's see. No, it's not Crowell this time. It's Carlton Thomas, of course. Crowell, a well-deserved breather on the sideline. Time ticking away. We might get one more playoff in the third. Yes, we will. Carlton Thomas gets horse-collared. We head to the fourth quarter in rainy San Diego. Michigan State, they are on the ropes. One score in the game, and it was on the big Hail Mary. It's Bulldogs 14, Spartans 7 as we head to the fourth. Murray is able to get his wide receiver for a first down pickup. That's King, of course. Georgia trying to extend it into a 2-score lead. Isaiah Crowell, touchdown, Georgia Bulldogs. 20-7, they take the lead over the Spartans. Spartans are this close to yet another early exit in the Bowl Championship Series playoffs. Kick is up, kick is good. Kick at about the 30. Of course, it's at the 30. I don't know what I'm saying. It's brought back up to the 20. Not a bad run back to the 27-yard line. Keyshawn Martin and guys like Martin Cunningham, they've been pretty quiet today in terms of receiving. They got to get things going for Sparty. They're down by 14. Kirk Cousins is going to get that one in there for 6 yards. Then we'll get to Lincecum. Second down, interception. Intercepted, Kirk Cousins. It didn't look like this was going to be his game today. Brandon Boykin, his wide receiver slipped in the rain. That's what happened. His wide receiver slipped, and that allowed Boykin to roll in and get the interception. Georgia Bulldogs are 4 minutes, 20 seconds away from moving on to face either LSU in an SEC championship rematch or Louisiana Tech in the second round. Crowell, nothing doing. He goes down. Look at him. He is a warrior. Look at that uniform. Just the dirt, the mud. These guys played their hearts out in the rain. Again, Crowell gets it. And really nice Spartan defense getting the backfield by Chris Norman, junior linebacker from Detroit. Third down and 12. Aaron Murray forced to throw it. Incomplete. Hold everything. We're thinking that Georgia's moving to the second round. There's still lots of time left, and this Spartan defense is able to force a quick three and out. Now they have to punt it away. And Kirk Cousins can score quick enough. They can still kick it deep. They have all three timeouts. It is not over yet. Let's hold everything. 3 minutes, 35 seconds to go. Three timeouts. Five wide receivers are set. No shot for a run. Cousins, open man. As good, I mean, Cousins has been doing a good job finding his receivers. They've been open, but you got to credit the Georgia defense because every time somebody from Michigan State catches it, there's a Georgia defender right there. There have not been many yards after catch. Cousins was hoping for yards after catch on that run. It's going to fall incomplete. Third down and 4. Again, 4 for 9 on third down conversions. That's nearly 50%. Not that bad at all. In the gun once again. Cousins going deep. Hail Mary-esque play. Brandon Boykin is there. Incomplete. Fourth down and 4, and Sparty's got to go for it. With 3 minutes to go, it's do or die time right now for Michigan State. They're going to have 4 wideouts. First down, Spartans. Out of bounds. Here comes the no huddle. That one was nabbed by B.J. Cunningham, top wide receiver leading his team. Kirk Cousins is going to run it. Here comes Kirk Cousins. He slides down after a 5-yard gain. Clock is ticking. Spartans need 2 touchdowns. Pressured. Great job on the block. Incomplete. Brandon Boykin again. How good is Brandon Boykin on defense? Third down and 5. Cousins desperately wants to go deep. He's going to try to run it down. Go Kirk Cousins. Sacked on the play by Christian Robinson, linebacker. 226 pounds. Mark Richt pulling him to the sideline. It's 4th and 11. Cousins, pressure, down he goes. Sacked once again. Jeff Rapp. And now I think we could all but assume that Georgia is going to be heading on to the next round to take on either LSU or Louisiana Tech. Isaiah Crowell gets it. Crowell down at the 20-yard line. Look at his day. I think he's going to be your player of the game. 130 yards rushing. Second down and 5. Timeout is called by Michigan State. Inside handoff. Isaiah Crowell He gets 1 yard on the run. It'll be third down and four, ball at the 19-yard line. Murray looking for the end zone. That one was batted away. So fourth down and four, they're going to have to kick the field goal. The field goal by Blair Walsh is good to give the Georgia Bulldogs a 17-point lead with 2 minutes to go in the football game. A lot of blowouts we've had here today in these BCS playoff early games, these Thursday games. First and 10. Ball at the 29-yard line for Cousins. Trying to get some more points on the board. Cousins is back. Cousins has no choice but to try to run it, and that's not going to do it. Bring everybody back. That's going to keep the clock rolling. Cousins finds himself face first in the turf once again, and Kurt decides to just spike it. Bring up a third down and 15. And what was a really good number for third down conversions has now slowly dwindled to a 4 for 11 in third down conversions. Cousins is deep, wide open receiver. That's going to be a Michigan State touchdown. So they finally find the scoreboard. B.J. Cunningham, who's got to have almost 150 yards receiving on his two touchdown grabs alone. The Spartans will cut the lead down. And unless they can get the onside kick. They got the one timeout. I don't think it'll be enough to make the comeback happen. But if you believe in miracles, we'll see. Onside kick is certainly coming up next for the Spartans. 24-14 is now your score. And here comes the onside kick. Bouncing around. Oh, it's touched. That's Michigan State football. It didn't go the 10 yards. I thought it was touched by a Georgia defender. That might be a really bad call. I know it didn't go the 10 yards, but Georgia came down. And I thought one of them kicked it. Well, we'll let you go back and look at it on your own. I thought for sure a Georgia player came in and kicked the ball, which would have meant it was live. The flags come out, though. Crowell just trying to run this clock out. They're going to let all 20 seconds of this run off the clock. On a third and five, it's looking like they're about to pass the ball. They are knocked away, so that will stop the clock. Georgia now has to settle for a field goal. Even if they make it, if they don't make it, what have you, it still remains a two-score game. Michigan State gets the ball back. They can make something interesting happen. It's going to be a 50-yard field goal. Kick is good. How about that leg? One more time. Just over the crossbar. Makes it 27 to 14. But by throwing it, you still, I mean, anything can happen. Michigan State, if they can quick score, onside kick, get it back, quick score again. This is a crazy sport, is college football. Let's look at game tracks. It's been Kirk Cousins and the pressure of the defense for this Georgia Bulldog team has put on him. That's why he hasn't quite had the effective day he'd been hoping he'd have. Five sacks, six hurries for Kirk Cousins. 36 seconds to go, they trail by 13 points. Five wide receivers. Cousins over the middle. Has an open man. There he goes. That's going to stop the clock temporarily. BJ Cunningham, here we go. We're moving down the field. Chains still have not been set. Cousins looks like he's going to spike it. He is. 27 seconds to go. Could you imagine if Michigan State could pull this thing off? They got 27 seconds. Cousins sends a man in motion. He's pressured. Gets rid of it. That's going to keep it rolling. That was desperation. If I was the running back, you got to try to think. Let that just fall to the turf. Let that be incomplete. Cousins spikes it. So they're going to get one more chance at it. One final heave. Fourth and 15. 15 seconds to go. And with 15 seconds, I almost got to think you've got to go for the end zone on this play. Hail Mary, Michigan State. Do they pull it off again with a Hail Mary? Cousins, you got to go for it, Kurt. There he goes. End zone. It's nabbed. That's going to be a Michigan State touchdown. Touchdown Spartans by Keyshawn Martin. So Michigan State makes it really interesting. Onside kick. Cousins found Martin. You see the missed tackle on the play. Missed tackle by the safety. Cummings, Sanders Cummings. And the Spartans with the extra point would make it a 6-point game. There it is. All right, onside kick. Spartan fans are on the edge of their feet. Five seconds to go. Here's the kick. It's bounced around and Georgia gets it. That's gonna do it. What a great last minute effort that was by Michigan State. Onside kick recovery, however. Orson Charles was the one that nabbed it on the hands team. Aaron Murray takes the knee. And the Georgia Bulldogs have moved on to the second round. They will meet up with either LSU or Louisiana Tech in the next round of 16. Take a look. There's your final score. Georgia 27, Michigan State 21. And here's your play of the game. How about this run from the young freshman, Isaiah Crowell, and the fact that this was play of the game, I could almost guess for you who the player of the game will be. And it should be Mr. Crowell. We see both coaches a whole lot of respect down there. Both players play their hearts out. That was a great game. Kirk Cousins, his senior year, that's going to be the last time you see him in a Spartan uniform. Wanted to go out with a win. But there you see him, 21 carries, 137 yards, and two touchdowns. And the Georgia Bulldog fans that made the long trip. If LSU wins, they can have a relatively short trip. In fact, the Chick-fil-A Bowl, it would work out to their advantage because that would be right back in the Georgia Dome. So they made the long trip here to San Diego. They're hoping that LSU will take that Chick-fil-A Bowl. Maybe LSU won't take the Chick-fil-A Bowl to try to make the fans have to travel. Another option for the LSU Tigers, if they do pull off the win, would be to go to Texas, maybe play in one of those bowl games, or maybe go to Memphis, play in the Liberty Bowl. Anything's a possibility. We'll see what happens. But here's your highlights, and I don't think you can doubt the heart of this Michigan State team, the way they tried to fight and come back. Those long heaves to the end zone. And Kirk Cousins was determined, without a doubt, to try to make this thing happen. Cunningham making some plays happen. And, of course, there's Keyshawn Martin. Some final screenshots. We're going to get some final numbers. And then that's it for today. Unless if you haven't watched the Meineke Car Care Bowl of Texas, you got one more in you. If not, that's going to do it for today. Let's take a look at these stats, player stats. Aaron Murray, 11 for 20. No touchdowns, but he didn't throw a pick, 130 yards. On the other side, Kirk Cousins, 346 yards, three touchdowns, 20-23. When you look at rushing, Edwin Baker, 11 tries, 1 yard, not good at all. Bell had one try for 2 yards, I mean, and then you look at the other side. 21 attempts, 137 yards, two touchdowns for Isaiah Crowell for receiving. You had Bennett, you had King do their thing. Michigan State, Cunningham, 4 receptions, 147 yards, 2 touchdowns. For defense, Robinson led him in tackles. But you got to take a look at where's Boykin on the Georgia Bulldog. He was the one that really impressed me today. Only 3 tackles, but where's those deflections? Pass deflections. You get credit for 2 of them, but he was there on quite a few plays. And, of course, he had the 1 interception. So Brandon Boykin did really well on defense. Team stats, wrapping this one down. First downs pretty even. Spartans almost had 100, almost had 50 more yards of total offense. Negative 17 rushing yards compared to the 162 for Georgia. When you look at that, I mean, the passing yards there, Sparty got them. They even got them on the third down conversions. But it was just more clutch plays when they needed it to for Georgia. Bulldogs, they're on to the next round. Let's go ahead and take a look at those brackets. There you have it. You see that in this bracket, we've had Georgia and Texas. Both move on to the second round. Who is going to join them? Kansas State, Auburn, LSU, Louisiana Tech. They still have to play, and those will be coming up in the next couple of days here on the BCS Playoffs.